So are there limits to how much genetic change you can have happen, like in an organism? So could you go, let's say, from dinosaurs to birds, because that's what evolutionists, believe. And again, the answer is no, because when you start the amount of you can't just I always say you can't take the genome of one organism, tweak it, and get the genome of a completely different organism. It doesn't work that way. When you think about it, the mutations, like even let's say you got, let's just give them this. So they get one protein that may help them in the formation of feathers that would help dinosaurs form feathers. Because it's lots of proteins. It's not just one. It's not just one gene. It's lots of genes that are required for that. So even if you get that one, you still can't form a feather. So how do you then, why is that organism going to survive better and do better than any other dinosaur alive at that time? And because it's all about survival of the fittest, so it's probably not. And so that organism is going to die. Well, so does that information. And maybe it was passed on, maybe not. But then how do you wait then for the next protein to form and the next, I mean, it's just not plausible to even get one of those in the first place. But the fact that you have to get a bunch of them to form a feather, and you don't just have to get, what I try to tell people is it's not just about getting all the proteins, all of the DNA that you need, the genes you need to form the feather. You have to be able to regulate it properly. And that's a whole nother level of complexity that you're adding to this. It has to be at the right time in the right place. How do you evolve that by random chance? I mean, it's just ludicrous to think that that can happen.